Students will discuss today about linear expansion in solid. As we have categorized our solid into three parts, three types. One is a linear, one dimensional solid, two dimensional solid, and three dimensional solid. One dimensional solid is like a rod whose other dimensions are neglected. Plate whose two dimensions are considered, the length and breadth and thickness is neglected, that is a two dimensional object. And in case of a three dimensional object, the length, breadth and height all are three dimensions are considered, so they are three dimensional objects. In this case, we will discuss only about the linear expansions in solid, means we will consider one dimensional object and see how the dimension increases, how that length increases. So, definition is expansion of length of a rod upon heating. Okay. Due to heat. That is enough. It is the expansion of length of the solid due to heat. So, we'll explain about linear expansion and we'll derive the final length of a rod when heated from one temperature to another temperature, it will expand. So, its initial or original length will change. If the original length will change, then what will be its final length corresponding to that temperature or rise? So, this we will discuss. Let us consider a rod of length L naught. This is a rod whose length is L naught. Right here, length of the rod. This 0 stands for temperature. At 0 degree centigrade. This is the length of the rod. So if you are using centigrade scale, let the rod is at temperature 0 degree centigrade. I measure the length of the rod when the temperature is 0 degree centigrade and it is found to be L naught. Next, you apply heat. When you apply heat, its temperature will rise. Let the temperature rise. And with the rise in temperature, the body must be expanding, the length must be increasing. I will stop at any temperature, say T. When I stop at any temperature T, again I measure the length corresponding to that temperature T. I find the length is something else because expansion has occurred. The length is found to be LT. Any T degree centigrade. So, if I say that this is the length, now that is increase in length. This was the original length, and I suppose that this is the small amount of extension that occurs in both sides of the rod. This is suppose the metal rod. And this final length is LD from here to here. This length is LT, and from here to here, this length is L0. From here to here, the length is L0 because here the temperature was 0 degree centigrade. Now here the temperature is at T degree centigrade. Okay, so when the temperature of the rod is 0 degree centigrade, this length is L0. When the temperature is T degree centigrade, this length becomes LT. That means this is the amount of extension or expansion that has occurred in terms of its dimensions. Now, our aim is to find the final length, that is LT, corresponding to any temperature given to you. Or for any temperature change or rise, we must know to find the length of the given rod. So, we have to derive the expression for the final length. So, let us derive that. expression for final length of the rod at a certain temperature, T degree centigrade. So just like the thing we discussed, this is the continuity that we discussed, the length is L0 and this is the length corresponding to T degree centigrade is LD. Okay. It is found from the experiment that this is corresponding, this I'm writing with respect to the diagram that we draw before this, that is the length is L0 at temperature 0 degree centigrade, length is LT at temperature T degree centigrade. It is found that the increase in length of the rod increasing length of the rod is directly proportional to the original length at 0 degree centigrade. And second point, that the increase in length is directly proportional to the rise in temperature. Okay, so these two factors, it depends upon these two factors that we are finding the expressions for final length, and it is found that the increase in length depends upon these two factors, increase in length. So rise in temperature, you write delta T, rise in temperature, original length at 0 degree centigrade, original length at 0 degree centigrade, this means it is L0. Increase in length, this means LT minus L0. So what relation are getting? LT minus L0, the final length of the rod at T degree centigrade, and the length before, previously it was at 0 degree centigrade, the difference in length is increase in length. That increase in length is LT minus L0 is proportional to the length of the rod at 0 degree centigrade, that is L0, and rise in temperature delta T. Putting these two inequalities together, we'll have one equation that we are going to write. So we can write LT minus L0 these two equalities. Now combining these two, we have LT minus L0 delta T. Removing this proportional sign, we will have some constant here. Introducing equality sign, you introduce also a constant. That constant is alpha L0 delta T. This alpha is called coefficient of linear expansion of solid. This is called coefficient of linear expansion. So I'll write here where alpha is coefficient of linear expansion. Now LD becomes, from this equation you can rearrange this, L0 goes to the right side of the equation and becomes plus of L0, and earlier it was there, so L0 alpha delta T. If I take L0 common from these two terms, then I will be left with 1 plus alpha delta T. This will be, this is the final length of the rod. If the initial length and alpha and delta T are given to us, then we will find the final length of the rod. This is the final length. This T stands for the temperature corresponding to this length. T stands for the temperature. Now we'll discuss more about the coefficient of linear expansion, then also define that coefficient of linear expansion, and write the unit of this. So here, as we have derived the equation, we'll define now definition. Coefficient of linear expansion. Now LT is L0 1 plus alpha delta T. This is what you have got. Okay. Now this coefficient of linear expansion, this is a constant. That constant depends upon the material. The first few points you must know that alpha depends on material. So alpha is different for a rod of made up of copper or iron or steel or aluminium. So as you change the material, the alpha value will change. That means alpha for copper is not same as alpha for iron. As you change the material, the alpha value will change. Next point you must note about alpha is that the value of alpha is of the order of 10 to minus 5 or minus 6. It's a very small number. Order is 10 raised to minus 5. This is a very small quantity. So therefore, third is the square of alpha, or when you find higher orders of alpha, it should be neglected or should be 0, because the order is very, very small. Squaring it, it is too small. 10 raised to minus 5 square is 10 raised to minus 10. So it is too small. Square alpha, square or alpha q terms will be neglected. So these three points you have to remember, that alpha coefficient of linear expansion is a material specific, depends on material, its property depends on material. It doesn't depend upon this LT, L0 or delta T, how you change the temperature of the solid. Okay, if you may change or may not change, that doesn't matter, the alpha will remain same. If you take the initial length more at 0 degree centigrade, or you take initial length smaller at 0 degree centigrade, that also doesn't change alpha. So alpha basically depends on the material that you choose, the material that is under concentrations. Next is to define this coefficient of linear expansion alpha, we'll make alpha a subject and put other things, rearrange them to the other side of the equations. So this will be alpha equals to LT minus L0 divided by L0 delta T. This is how you write alpha. Okay, because earlier this was the equation that this is proportional to these two together. So from that equation directly I can write that alpha is this. So how you define alpha? It is the increase in length per original length at 0 degree centigrade per degree rise in temperature. So it is defined like this. Definition will write here you can take a rod, or you can take other like a solid. Okay, so this is how we define alpha, that it is the increase in length, that is LT minus L0, per original length, that is L0, per degree rise in temperature, that is delta T. So unit of alpha will be LT minus L0. So this way unit of this is meter, unit of this is a meter, unit of this is Kelvin, or degree centigrade if you want, right? Okay, so this cancels, and this is Kelvin raised to minus 1, or you can write degree centigrade minus 1. Okay, so per degree centigrade is the unit of alpha. Okay.